We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
And no matter where we go on tour, see us coast to coast, we take it.
Notes like Mariah, God's gift to me, yeah, Messiah. Sex is wearing me out, oh boy, I'm tired.
All right, guys, what's going down? It's your girl Jennifer Tapier, and it's time to chill with Jen. This is Just Chilling with Jen out here on LA Talk Live broadcast. We're making it happen over here. And that's our song, Haters Be Quiet, with my amazing boyfriend Sam Stone singing and the black girl and me rapping on that track. So welcome to the show, everybody. It's going to be a great show. We got a lot of things going on. We also have an actress stopping by the show, and we have a stylist stopping by, so it'll be a good time. So much is happening. Okay, I was wondering why I've been so sick. Okay. I had food poisoning. Richard, I had food poisoning. That's why I was so damn sick for the past, like, 2 weeks.
Too much eating at Mr. Chow's.
No, I don't eat at Mr. Chow's. It was too much banana bread from my neighbor. Like, don't ever accept food from your neighbor, people. Like, even though you might know them, don't accept
now,
it.
Now, don't disseminate that message. Yes, accept food.
I'm just joking.
From your neighbor.
Yeah, I ate this banana bread, and man, it all went downhill from there. Like a bad. Like I had fever, hot chills. I was about to go to the hospital. That guy came in on Thursday night. I was like, I'm so sick. I felt like I was going to collapse. Banana bread. Can you imagine?
Yeah, you know, banana bread can be a little sketchy.
Yeah, you're telling
you know,
me,
banana,
dude.
I guess I shouldn't be. Bananas, that alone.
What could go wrong? All the
yeah.
bananas spoiling or what?
Well, that's one of them. And then the bread itself, you know, that can get moldy because the banana bread can be very heavy and...
it wasn't good.
Yeah.
It wasn't.
And moisture, you know, like you don't want dry banana bread. You want banana bread that's kind
of
moist?
It tasted so good as I was eating it, too.
Most of the stuff that make you do that do taste good.
2 weeks later, I'm, like, recovering. I was so freaking sick. I was going to go to the ER. I'm like, what the hell's wrong with me? And I figured it out. I had food poisoning, so it kind of sucked.
Aww.
But we're going to dedicate the next few minutes for the callers to call in, chat with us, join in the conversation. I want to know how your weekend was. What did you do to chill? I was chilling. Yesterday, I got a facial. That felt really good. I like to do stuff like that, but I haven't gotten a facial in like months, and it's just the most relaxing feeling getting a facial. Have you ever gotten a facial?
But of course,
very fancy, very fancy.
Indeed, I've had
it feels really good.
In my lifetime.
I had a facial and a massage this weekend.
I need one right now.
You need a massage and a facial?
Rub my face. Somebody call in and rub my face through the phone, why don't you?
But yeah, I was chilling. I got a nice massage, got a facial. I was sick as a dog. Great Saturday, you know, night I spent on the couch almost throwing
Poor
up.
Thing.
I was sick as a dog.
Can I talk a little bit about my weekend?
Yeah, what's up with your weekend? Tell
so
me about
you know,
your weekend.
Saturday was just a day off. Came in for a little while, worked a little while, and, you know, had a nice relaxed day. It was an incredible day because, you know, we've got a show on Saturday called Band with Mondo. With Mondo and Lixie the Engineer.
Uh-huh.
And they always bring in the most incredible musicians and music and talent.
Uh-huh.
They had a one-man band in here. He stood there with all these lit gadgets. I didn't even know what he was doing, creating all this incredible sound. So big ups to Band
big
with
ups
Mondo's.
To, big ups to the one-man band, man.
to the
That's
one-man
crazy.
Band. Don't know the guy's name. But my God, it sounded like there was a whole band in here.
Shut up.
So that was my Saturday. But Sunday, the reason I wanted to talk about my weekend is because I got up Sunday morning, and all of a sudden I heard some loud cacophony outside my window. You know, all this noise, just but musically related. And I said, man, somebody's got a heckified, let me just say it, keep it real, hellified sound system in their car, right? And then I realized, no, that's not a sound system because it's not moving away from my window.
Right.
I went outside, and behold, what did I see?
The shuttle.
No. Saw that the other day. I saw the Caribbean Festival marching down Manchester Boulevard, heading towards the park just beyond the golf course.
Uh-huh.
there were kids and women and men, and the great Caribbean music from reggae to Belizean.
Oh, that's sick.
And there were these big trucks with the music blaring with the huge speakers on the back of them and all these incredible dancers behind them doing their thing. And
you're
it was
hilarious.
Amazing. It was like 10 in the morning.
So from your window, you saw them.
Well, I heard it first and I couldn't see it. And I was like, what is that? Went outside and there it was. And they had stopped right at Manchester and Emerson.
Oh, no way.
And they just stood there and just danced and partied for a while. And then they'd move on.
Did you party with them?
Well, on the sidelines, yeah.
A lot of action has been going on around the LAX airport. I mean,
I
the shuttle.
I wanted to get out there and walk with them. And
I haven't seen the shuttle. Tell me about that, man. I saw on Van's Facebook, he posted a picture of the shuttle. But it was literally like outside.
The shuttle was right down the block, Jen. If you had been here,
that's sick.
You could have went.
Thank God
right
I wasn't.
The
All the traffic
lot.
Would have been horrible.
Well, if you'd parked early,
yeah,
and then went across the street up a block, it was right there.
I saw the shuttle a few weeks ago, and I was first of all, I was with my boyfriend, and his dad's like, "You guys should have got up earlier and went to see the shuttle." We're like, what are we gonna do? You know, so we're just driving to the beach. All of a sudden, I'm just driving to
the
Manhattan
shuttle
beach.
Right in front of you, like, hey,
the shuttle was right above us.
Oh wow!
So I tried. I was like, "What are the chances of that?" I'm like, on this intersection, I look up, the shuttle's right there. And I'm
the
like,
wing right above your head.
It was just right there. I'm like, that's so cool. So I was, making history as I was driving.
Well, honestly, I did not get up
early enough
and walk one block. Well, I always get up early enough. And I didn't get up and feel motivated to walk one block to go down and watch the shuttle be dragged up the street right down the block from me. I have to say, and I might, maybe I shouldn't say it on your show. Maybe
say
I
it.
Should wait.
What?
I think the shuttle is the biggest billion-dollar hunk of junk in the world. Because now it's heading to the damn museum. And I can understand the allure of wanting to go out and see a real spaceship. Because that's what you're
we
looking at.
We should have smacked our logo
but the
on
fact
that shuttle.
Of the matter
LA Talk
is,
Live.
I haven't gained a single thing from the shuttle.
No? Nothing.
They spent billions of dollars. And, over the weekend while they were moving the shuttle, they did several different marathons about the development of the space science and space technology in America and how it evolved to the shuttle and how many absolute failures there were. We have to remember that one of the shuttles blew up. And
that's scary.
Respects to the astronauts who and their families who perished in that, one of the first failures of a space shuttle. I looked at this programming while they were pulling that shuttle through the street and realized, wow, we spent billions and billions and billions
of
dollars. And after repeated failures, we kept feeding that NASA program and JBL and all of those organizations billions of dollars. But inevitably, they got one to work.
That shuttle has a good
publicist.
That's all I know.
Yeah, but inevitably, they got one to work.
We should have smacked the logo on there. You know how big we'd be
LA
right
Talk
now?
LA Talk Live, yeah.
This LA Talk Live.
We'd be big, but you'd be in jail.
I'd be in trouble. Imagine I did that overnight. I just painted
we'll
our logo.
Put some money
logo.
On your books. That's all. Yeah,
that's crazy. All but sounds like it's a good weekend, man. Mm. I was chilling.
I woke up Sunday morning to that Caribbean Festival, and it really lightened up my day. And of course, it's football Sunday. Football.
What's going on in the football world?
Oh, everything. I don't really know. I don't keep up with it like
you don't
that.
Keep
I just
up.
Watch it for entertainment's sake.
Really?
Sure.
Yeah, I was walking around my neighborhood yesterday. I just hear people screaming, and they're in their jerseys. I can see from the window. Everyone's partying. It gives people an excuse to party on the Sunday, right? Even if you don't watch football, you're like, I'm watching football.
It is an American tradition as true as apple pie.
So who's your team? I mean, you're from Philly. You're from the East Coast.
I'm kind of riding with the Eagles this year because
okay.
I want to see Mike Vick and them do something.
Yeah,
I know they're not going to make
what's
it.
What's up with Mike Vick? What's going on?
He's too small. He needs a core of offensive linemen in front of him who are as fast mm-hmm. and fleet of foot as he is. Because Michael Vick is very fast. And he can make moves midstream that the average linemen, who are huge guys, like 6'7", 6'10", 300 to 350 pounds, offensive linemen, they're really big guys. So when Mike zigs left, they zig right.
He has a documentary, actually. I was going to watch it on Netflix, but I decided not to.
Oh, I wish I'd known that. I saw a terrible documentary this weekend on Netflix about the Obama secret. What a bunch of crap.
You didn't like it?
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I've been watching a lot of
$4
Netflix.
$4 I spent
really?
In
is
a
that
long time.
Can't you get Netflix and it's like a monthly thing for $7?
Well, it wasn't really, it didn't really cost me anything.
You're still
Katrina,
pissed off.
My beloved girlfriend, has a... hookup, and she gets these movies sometimes for free. But I really thought that was one lousy movie. So I didn't see any good movies this weekend.
I saw... I've been watching the Shark Week documentary. I'm so scared. I've been watching Shark Week on my Netflix. I'm so freaking scared to go in the ocean now.
Yeah, you're chum.
I am scared. Like,
you're
watch,
chum.
I'm telling you. A white girl like me.
Yeah, you're chum.
With a booty. Sharks are lovely. I'm so freaking scared. But lots is going on, you know, on TMZ. I've been checking it out. And it looks like... Kanye West and Kim Kardashian maybe are planning to have a little baby. I don't know. That's what all people are talking. Really? Everyone's talking about it. But it's because Reggie Bush is having a child. He called into a radio station last week and was talking about how he is expecting a child. So I think it'd be cool to see Kim and Kanye have a baby.
I didn't know they had gotten that deep. If there was going to be
obviously
somebody...
Obviously, Kanye got deep. Because if they're going to be having a baby soon.
You're so nasty. But I would have thought the Ballhead Beast. I forget her name now. They called her the Ballhead Beast. The girl that, you know, became famous.
Amber Rose. Dating Wiz Khalifa. She's dating him. Actually, she's pregnant, too.
I'm about to say,
so everyone in that circle, Amber Rose is pregnant, Reggie Bush is having a baby, so maybe Kim Kardashian is next.
Ladies, watch where you sit. You never know.
I'm scared. Any pregnant people sit in this chair?
Pregnancy is in the air.
Yeah, you know what? Actually, speaking of movies, I saw the movie with Snoop Dogg and Wiz Khalifa. It's called High School. And Wiz Khalifa, that was his first movie, and he killed it. I don't know if he was just so stoned he did such a good job. But he was just, I don't know if he was just in character or what, because he plays this really smart guy, you know, this valedictorian, and then he meets with Snoop Dogg and bada bing, bada boom, no longer valedictorian.
Wow.
Now he is. He's really good, though. It's a really good movie. You guys should go check it out. I thought it was sick. Oh, so I'm going to drop this song, too. This is the new Kanye West, Jay-Z, Big Sean, Click. Nobody's messing with my click, my LA Talk Life entourage. What? We're going to take a break. So, well, let's drop this track. And then when we come back, let's talk with some callers. The phone number is 323-247-7443. And then we got some celebrities in the house. So we'll be right back. Click, click. I love this song.
Click. Ain't nobody fresher than my motherfucking click, 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 click. As I look around, they don't do it like my click, 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 click. And all these bad bitches, man, they want the, they want the. Tell a bad bitch, do whatever I say. My block behind me like I'm coming out the driveway. It's grind day from Friday to next Friday. I've been up straight for 9 days, I need a spy day. Yup. She try and give me that Wu-Tang. I might let my crew bang. My crew deep in that Wu-Tang. I'm rolling with her. Fuck I'm saying. Girl, you know my crew name. You know 2 Chainz. I'm pulling up in that Bruce Wayne. But I'm the fucking villain. Man, they kneeling when I'm walking in the building. Freaky women I be feeling. From the bank accounts I'm feeling. What a feeling. Aw, oh, man, they gotta feel. Young player from the D that's killing everything that he's fucking with. No. Click, 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 oh, click, click. Ain't nobody fresher than my motherfucking click, 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 click. As I look around, they don't do it like my click, 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 click. And all these bad bitches, man, they want the, they want the, they want the.
Click, clap, stick them up. Yeah, I'm talking yeah. Yeah, I'm talking re. Yeah, I'm talking B. Nigga, I'm talking me. Yeah, I'm talking bossy. I ain't talking Khalees. Your money too short, you can't be talking to me. Yeah, I'm talking LeBron. We ballin' our family tree. Good music, drug dealing, cousin, ain't nothing fucking with we. Me, turn that 62 to 125, 125 to a 250. 250 to a half a man, ain't nothing nobody could do with me. Now who with me? Dominoes, call me Hov or Hefe. Translation, I'm the shit. At least that's what my neck say. At least that's what my check say. Lost my homie for a decade. Nigga down for like 12 years. Ain't hugging son since the second grade. He never told. Who we gonna tell? We top of the totem pole. It's the dream team. Meets the supreme team. And all our eyes green. It only means one thing. You ain't fucking with the click.
Click, 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 click. Ain't nobody fresher than my motherfucking click, 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 click. As I look around, they don't do it like my click.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hey, Los Angeles, are you getting out to vote on Tuesday, November 6, 2012? I know I am. Hey, this is Richard Carr, General Manager for LA Talk Live, encouraging all the citizens of Los Angeles to get out and vote on Election Day 2012. As you know, this is one of the most important elections in our American history, and we need everyone in LA to register, vote, and have a voice on November 6, 2012. If you haven't registered to vote, don't even worry about it. You've got until midnight, October 22nd. And now you can even register to vote right online. That's right. If you have a signature file online with the DMV or a state-issued ID number, you can now register to vote at registertovote.ca.gov. That is registertovote.ca.gov. And be sure to tune in on Tuesday, November 6, 2012, for LA Get Out and Vote, broadcasting live all day right here at LA Talk Live and the Talk Live Broadcast Network. We'll be broadcasting live Election Day coverage from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., keeping you tuned into Election Day news all day right here on LA Talk Live, the world's only reality radio network where it's more than just talk. Now, LA, get out there and make some change.
This shit is highly sophisticated. I just make it look easy, nigga. Follow me. I'm so sophisticated. To get a verse from me, you gotta be initiated. To get a verse from me, she gotta
I feel like doing that every time. Welcome back to the show. Just chilling with Jen. What's going on, guys? It's your host, Jennifer Tapier, and we are just chilling out here at the LA Talk Live studio. By the way, we got the phone lines wide open for everybody at home. So give us a call at 323-247-7443. And make sure you guys are checking out my Facebook, Jennifer Tapiero, and check out StarCam Celebrities on Facebook and YouTube. So you can check out some celeb interviews. Lots is going on. A lot is going on the red carpet. I think I'm heading out to an event tonight with Tyler Perry. So hope I interview his ass.
What exactly is going on the red carpet these days?
So
update us, please.
So much is going on. I mean, we are out there like a few times a week at least, you know, trying to cover charities and stuff. But I know tonight I'm probably going to head out to this event with Tyler Perry. I just got the call last minute. And with these red carpet events, it's always so last minute. I got the call from the publicist. They send you over. Got to do the interviews last minute. But apparently Tyler's going to be there. So I heard he might be doing this movie where he plays like, I don't know if I got this right, but he's going to be playing like this action movie or something.
Tyler, tough guy, yeah.
Yeah, tough guy.
Real tough guy, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know. What do you
Madea.
Think?
Madea.
Madea.
Tough guy. From Madea to tough guy.
Yeah.
I think when Madea went to jail, came out tough guy.
Ah, Pellegrino was
flipped.
Amazing.
Got flipped in jail.
Yeah?
Madea did.
Yeah.
Right. I saw the trailers for that movie.
How does it look?
If you got enough money, you can buy enough action in a movie, right? But Madea, you know, you got to dress the wig off. You know, of course it wasn't Madea.
Mm-hmm.
It's Tyler Perry.
Right.
You know, all these lovable characters that he creates in all these movies and
so
TV
you don't think
shows.
It's that,
and it's hard.
Yeah.
It's a hard sell.
Yeah.
I saw the trailer. I could be wrong. Tyler, give us a call. Give him
I
number,
feel you. There's a lot of good movies out though right now. Argo, I heard, with Ben Affleck is supposed to be freaking amazing, and George Clooney produces it. I would love to see that. Those are some of my favorite actors, so I would love to check that out.
Denzel's got a new movie out.
Oh, you know what? I just love Denzel, man.
Denzel and Don Cheadle.
Yeah.
In a movie.
What a cast.
Where
huh?
Denzel is a pilot, and there's a plane crash, but he saved lives. You know, but. He'd had a couple sips.
He was drinking that night.
A libation before he got on the plane and
Ooh.
Flew it.
That looks like it's going to be a good movie.
So
everyone's talking
thickens.
About it.
Yeah, and when you put Don Cheadle in there, I forget the name of the movie.
Should be good. Really
wow,
good.
Wow, yeah. Denzel.
That's gonna, I think I was actually Still listening to a radio it. Interview recently. They were talking about Denzel. But, you know, I had some funny scenarios with Denzel. Every time I interview Denzel on the
now?
Red carpet, it's
Please
crazy.
Do tell.
Did I tell you about that one time?
No, go ahead.
Okay, well, basically, I was interviewing Denzel Washington, and I was on the red carpet at the Unstoppable premiere, and every question I would ask him, his wife would answer. So I'm thinking in my head, am I talking to Denzel, or am I talking to the wife, you know? I didn't sit here for 4 hours to talk to the wife. So she's answering all the questions. And
perhaps
she was
talking to the vision of what his wife thinks he might cheat with.
Very funny. Very funny. But every question I would ask him, the wife would answer. And then I asked him this one question about, like, you know, what does it take to be an unstoppable actor? And then she looks around and she's like, what? Like, what was that? Like, she was trying to, like, make me look stupid. Like, Denzel, what does that mean, you know? So then after that, I was kind of upset about the interview. And I got a phone call a few days later. Hey, you want to go fly to New York tonight and go interview Denzel again? This is your chance. I'm like, oh, yes, I'm going to do this. So I get out to New York, and I'm interviewing Viola Davis on the red carpet. And we're talking about how Denzel's a funny guy. I can joke with him. She's like, you know, Jen, he was such a nice guy. He even brought us lunch. And I thought she said brought his lunch. But really, she said bought us lunch. Like, he would buy them lunch every day. So I wanted to mess with Denzel. And I was like, Denzel, you know, what's up, man? How are you? He's like, how you doing, you know? And I was like, you know, in New York, it's freezing. Well, pot. Like, he's just, like, giving me a hard time again. I'm like, you're my favorite actor. Like, give me a break. So I'm like, hey, Denzel, you know, Viola was talking so highly about you before. She said that you were so sweet, you know, and you're fun, and you're so down to earth, you even brought your lunch to set. And he turned purple. He's like, I ain't packed no lunch. Like, he was so pissed off that I would ask Denzel Washington if he would pack, like, a brown paper bag lunch. And it didn't end up that good.
Guess she won't be getting the exclusive from Denzel on the new movie.
He was pissed off. Like, I'm asking him, do I pack a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, you know?
Right.
So that was my like little...
Your Denzel moment.
Yeah. And I turn around and my uncle's laughing so hard. He's like, you asked Denzel if you brought lunch. But you guys can go check that out on YouTube. It's got so many hits now.
Oh, really?
It got so many hits because it's funny. It's stupid.
I got to go check that out. I haven't seen it.
It was hilarious.
You've got so much stuff on YouTube.
You're such a
big star.
Oh, get out of here. Get out of here.
I'll go on.
For ladies out there, you know what? You want to lift up those boobs, but you don't want to get a breast implant. You don't want to get breast implants. It says if you do a little bit of push-ups, not those crazy, crazy push-ups, but what Cosmo is saying right here, it's saying if you do just you don't want to try too hard push-up, you know, one of those little push-ups. But if you do those, apparently it lifts up your boobs. So
you do them on your knees.
No.
Right? No. God, jeez. Let me rephrase that.
Yeah, rephrase that, Richard.
Stretch out like a regular push-up.
Exactly.
But instead of using your toes as your counterbalance, you use your knees. So it takes some of the stress off the back.
Exactly.
Especially if you don't have well-developed pectoral muscles.
Exactly. Gets the boobs looking nice. Sure. So I wanted to tell you guys that. You know, I always have my little beauty stuff. But I want to also talk about dry skin right now because it's like winter time. It's like 90 degrees here. Right. And I know my skin gets really dry because of this really like hot weather and then it's cold. So make sure you guys are using a really good moisturizer. Even for the men at home, make sure even in the morning, they're saying to use an oil-free and an oil-free daytime lotion would be really good with SPF. And then also, for the fellas, make sure you get something that doesn't break you out after you guys shave. So do you moisturize? You take care of your skin?
No.
You don't?
No. I just get up and I am this beautiful naturally.
Just wake up looking good.
And I've always been a natural beauty, quite frankly. So I've never really engaged in many beauty regimens in the morning.
Well, nice.
Yeah, and you know, I think the whole idea of a guy getting up in the morning and lotioning his body, and
that's good though. If you want to stay young,
I'm not feeling that.
You're not feeling
so
it.
So you know, I'm kind of ashy right now, and so.
But what you can do is that you can have your girlfriend put the lotion on you, so it's not as like.
Oh, then that's another 2 hours wasted. Or preoccupied, I should say. My girlfriend gonna go put lotion on.
She'll just give up. She's like, you too dry.
No.
You too dry.
That could get very involved.
Actually,
gets sticky
yeah.
when it's wet. You know.
Seriously, you can get involved. Add a little moisturizer, and then get all nice and looking good.
So I'm also going to have a beauty. She's actually from the Ty and Melissa and Ty show on CMT. Melissa Rycroft, who's on Dance with the Stars. Her beauty expert stopping by the show today. So we'll be talking about beauty stuff.
Word them up.
Yeah, she'll be here. We'll be talking about all the nice beauty products. But of course, you know, I work with Moonstar Cosmetics. It's a great makeup line. Check it out. They have
Big ups, Jade.
Big ups to Jade Martinez, who is the she's the founder and makeup artist, and she's the business person behind Moonstar. And everyone's loving it. All the celebrities are loving it. The concealer. I can't live without the concealer. So hit her up. We're going to give you guys a special. And also, for every person that likes our Facebook, Planet Love Match on Facebook, and if you like Moonstar on Facebook and StarCam Celebrities, we're going to give you guys a free makeover. So that's going to be hot. So like our Facebooks, and then make sure you leave a comment, and we will personally come give you guys a makeover. So for it's fall time. You want to look good. You want to maybe find a man. She can help you out with the right look. I know a lot of girls out there are just not wearing the right makeup. And I know I was there for a while. I wasn't matching the right colors. It was making me break out. So this company is a go-to amazing product. So go check it out, Moonstar Cosmetics. And I also want you guys to go check out European Wax Center. They have like the best waxing. They give you guys the best Brazilian waxes. And for the men, they do nose waxes and ear waxes and all that kind of stuff. So I'm working with them. Hopefully they will be sponsoring the show soon. They have the best wax ever. So if you guys want to look like a baby, pick it up. Like a little baby.
Like a baby.
God, so much is going on, man. I'm feeling good, though. I'm, like, really happy. I'm in such a good mood. So happy I don't have food poisoning and I'm not dying.
You got over it, yeah.
Got over it. Indeed. I got over it.
You're strong. You're young. You're vibrant. You're beautiful.
Yeah.
You should.
You know, yesterday I was having a hard time. I was thinking a lot about my dad and stuff. And I go through these moments where, like, it just kind of, like, hits me, you
hits
know?
You, yeah.
And I just had a little breakdown.
How many years has it been?
It's been 6 years when my dad passed.
Just never get over it sometimes, yeah.
It's hard. Like, some days I'll go and I'll just be talking about it, and I can just mention my father with just smiling. I can just smile and talk about it. But sometimes, like, I'll just be sitting there, and I'll just, like, think about it and think deep about, like, you know, life, and I would just start crying so much. And yesterday was hard, you know. Yesterday was one of those days where I felt like, man, this, like, I'm like, it was killing me, you know. And then today I feel really good. So I think that's part of the process,
you're
you know.
You're a survivor, girl.
It's part of the healing process. So anybody out there that's, you know, ever lost someone, or if they know somebody that's passed, or if you guys just want to call in to talk with me right now about it, give me a call. It's 323-247-7443. We're going to have a little bit of an open forum for all our viewers and our listeners and our callers. And I would love to talk about that. Like, what do you do when, you know, somebody you know passes away?
When
how do you cope?
It's hard to get over.
It's just so hard to get over sometimes, you know. But you know what I like to do? I like to talk about it and get it out there. And instead of sitting in my house and feeling like down and, you know, just because you can suck you in where you just get really sad about it, I was like, all right, I'm going to talk about this. So I went and I talked with my mom and got it out there, because I feel like a lot of people right now and a lot of children can't talk to their parents. Like, whatever's going on, you should be able to talk to your parents about it, whatever it is. It's a good way to open up and get things off your mind. So give us a call. We want to talk with you guys. Anything that's on your mind. It's 323-247-7443. That's 323-247-7443. And we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we have an actress from the movie Savages with John Travolta and Blake Lively. It's Amber Dixon Brenner in the house. So guys, stick around. We'll be right back in just a moment. This is Just Chillin' with Jen. Hope you guys are enjoying the show.
Check it. Check it. I'm the fucking man. Who the betcha? That other nigga's rap style is broken. Doo-doo, compared to this versatile voodoo. Blazing the stuff that ain't nice, then you're lacing inside ya. Cause I be that house of a mod, of a bar in the rhyme that be deep at the facade and adventure. Niggas need to test they freaking scripture for the sickness that be fighting with the quickness. Remedy, cause then I be doing all my enemies. Penalty, then I drink 40 to their memory. Emotion, crossing through your town, street vicinity. Blood smoke in the air, reveal my head.
LA Talk Live. We're more than just talk. Don't go anywhere. Stay tuned.
Hey, this is your girl, Paris, straight from the Cousins, and you can join us every Monday at 8 p.m. here live, bring you some great entertainment for those ears, exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream.tv, reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hey, what's up? It's your girl,
Forbidden Gems, inviting you to join us every Tuesday night at 9 p.m. sharp for the hottest, livest talk show, Forbidden Tuesdays.
Join us as we expose the new generation of love and dating and help y'all run a game right. Ladies, beware. Fellas, bring out your notepads.
So don't forget to tune in to
Forbidden Tuesdays
exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV. This is
LA Talk Live,
and we are more than just talk.
You ready?
Hi, this is Demetrius.
And I'm AJ, inviting you to join us every Tuesday at 5:30 for our all-new show, Real Talk with Demetrius and AJ.
We are your alternative to mainstream media's non-discussion of the real issues. No more sound bites, no more talking points, just real talk.
The guests on our show will include a wide array of people from all walks of life, elected officials, politically active celebrities, young leaders. And most importantly, you will all be included in this dialogue that is sure to be provocative and real.
So don't forget to tune in and listen to Real Talk with Demetrius and AJ every Tuesday at 5:30, exclusively on LATalkLive.com.
You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B, Live 365, Radio Flag, and now Stitcher Radio.
Or watch and listen directly at LATalkLive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure.
This is LA Talk Live.
And we are more than just talk.
Hi, this is Dawn Christie inviting you to join me every Friday, 1 p.m. Pacific, for my all-new show, The Dawn Christie Show. Join me as I discuss love, spiritual readings, your purpose, why am I born, what am I here to do? So don't forget to tune in The Dawn Christie Show at 1 p.m. Pacific, exclusively on LA Talk Live. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV, reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
That was a little Brandy for you guys. Welcome back to the show. It's Jennifer Tapier, just chilling out here at the LA Talk Live studio. Hopefully you guys have been enjoying the show. Like I said before the break, we have an actress in the studio. She just did a movie with Blake Lively. Let's welcome Amber Dixon Brenner from Savages. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Welcome. Congratulations on everything.
Thank you.
Oh my God, I heard so much about it. I haven't had a chance to check out the movie yet. But I'm a big fan of Travolta, so...
He's amazing.
Does he kill it in the film?
He kills it.
Oh, my goodness. So you were working with these great actors. At any point where you're like, okay, I got to pinch myself. Like, I can't believe I'm working with these people right now.
Absolutely. My first day on set, I worked with Benicio Del Toro.
Oh, my God.
It was a pinch me moment. It was like...
What did you do? You're like, holy crap.
I tried to stay composed.
Aww.
But I was so excited.
So did you tell him, like, I'm a big fan?
You know, I didn't say that. Mm-hmm. I just tried to absorb his greatness.
I'm like, you're awesome.
Right.
And you worked with Oliver Stone before, I heard.
Right. This is my second time with Oliver.
I want to hear about the first time you worked with him and how it ended up that you worked with him for a second time.
So I worked with him on Wall Street too, mm-hmm. because my husband has cut a few of his features.
Oh,
so
nice.
He's his film editor.
Oh, cool.
So I met him on Wall Street too. And I auditioned for a little role, mm-hmm. and I ended up playing the lead's little worker friend. And it was just a few lines, and then I had a small scene at the end. But it was great to get my feet wet and to meet, you know, very successful actors and work with Oliver Stone. Definitely, you kind of get a feel for him immediately.
What's he like?
Oh, whoa. What is Oliver like? He is smart, funny, intense, intelligent, generous, kind, compassionate, and
so you like the guy.
And fierce. And very fierce. And no bullshit.
I like that.
So, yeah.
I like no bullshit, man. There's so much bullshit out here in LA.
Right, yeah. There's none with him.
Awesome. So you work with him on this first movie. You did a bunch of, you know, scenes, you said, and then the second movie, Savages. How did that end up that you started to, you know, do this movie?
So Savages, what's the story on that? I heard about it through friends, and I called my manager and I said, hey, can you get me an audition on this project? So he was trying to work it. And meanwhile, I tapped into any resource I had, and, you know, I was hustling it, and my manager was. And then I finally had an audition, you know, like most actors, and went in, and I read for a very small role. They ended up cutting that role. And then Oliver liked my tape, and so he brought me back on and expanded the role into into a woman in the cartel. So it was a great gift from higher source.
That's sick. You play a pretty badass character, I heard. You're a little bit evil, aren't you?
Yeah, for sure.
You
for
do some
sure.
bad things to Blake Lively's character, I heard.
I do some bad things to her character. Whether or not I'm evil, I don't know. I have a much more... an open mind about about where people are coming from and why they do the things they do. And I just tried to get into the headspace of what would make this woman want
do such
to
things.
Yeah, do such things, right?
Was it cool working with Blake? She's a great actress.
Yeah, it was cool working with Blake. It really was. Yeah, she's interesting. I saw her perform a great monologue. So yeah, it was good.
That is really cool. So you do some crazy things to her character. I haven't seen the movie yet. What could you tell us what you do in the film?
So my character starts out by stalking Blake to basically help our cartel boss, Salma Hayek, get Blake and kidnap her and hold her hostage so that her two boyfriends basically do what the cartel asks for, which is to... open their business up and sell drugs on their behalf. So to expand the business. Yeah. So
that's so cool. That's a pretty badass character.
Yeah. It's very badass character.
I have
really
to say,
is.
Salma Hayek has great hair products. I just went to CVS and I picked up her curling cream, and I used it today for like the second
Your
time.
Your hair looks great.
Thanks, girl. Salma Hayek's curling cream.
I
never worked
try
with
it
Salma,
out.
But you did.
I did. She's
I'm
amazing.
I'm working with Salma from CVS.
Yeah. Yeah, it looks really good.
Thanks, girl. So you work with Salma a little bit. You had some scenes with her. Is she awesome?
She's wonderful. Amazing actress. A girl's girl, but she's a woman's woman. You know, she's helpful and... interesting and enigmatic. She's wonderful.
Did she give you any advice or anything on set?
Not really. There was one time she really helped me out. I was giving a line and it was in Spanish and I screwed it up on camera, and so I came back in and she was like, Amber, no, it was this or that. And I was like, shit.
You probably sound like a curse word in Spanish. You're like, that wasn't the right word.
I screwed up the line, and then but nobody was really speaking a lot of Spanish on this set. So she and I knew that I screwed up, but so she was helpful, but she was always really fun and a deep, wonderful spirit to be around.
What a great cast. Congratulations. Yeah. That's a big role.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Savages. I mean, what a cast too. Like when I saw John Travolta, I was like, oh my God, John Travolta. I love him. Like I interviewed him and I love that guy.
Yeah, you should definitely see it, because I would say in the film my favorite scene is between him and Benicio.
Really?
And they have this like amazing
intense.
It's just wonderful. It captures the whole story and just beautiful acting.
Ah, when you look back at your performance, what was like your favorite scene? What were you most proud of?
My favorite scene. Probably I would say the most intense scene that took a lot to do, which you wouldn't really know from watching the picture, mm-hmm. was when she woke up in the hostage house and she was being slapped around. That was a lot of, it was a lot of work to sustain that sort of violence.
And how do you get into the character? It's kind of dark, you know? I wouldn't know what to do. I'd be scared.
What do you do? Well, I think, you know, if you're trained to do that, or you have a gift to do it, or I think you come to terms with the psychology behind why people are motivated to do certain things, and then you try to lend service to that archetype.
Right. Did you do any Googling when you were trying to do some research?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
A lot of Googling, a lot of research. Went down to Mexico, the whole thing, just really absorbed.
What? Yeah. You went down to Mexico?
Yeah, that's went down so to cool. Mexico. So, yeah, just tried anything and everything to really get the feel of what the piece was about and how to bring something to it.
Awesome. Everyone was talking about it. So I can't wait to check it out. I've been wanting to see it. I haven't really been to the movies lately. So I'm like, I got to check up all my movies.
Yeah, go do it.
I have
go
to.
See it. Go check
I got
it out.
Everyone has to go check out Savages. She does a really good job. What's the name of the character that you play?
Sophia.
Yeah. So you can check her out in that. And any other projects right now that you're working on that we can be on the lookout for?
I'm considering doing a play.
Okay.
So,
very cool.
That might be something that I'll do. And I'm just, you know, reading a lot of different scripts and auditioning and doing the Hollywood hustle. So.
Definitely. The Hollywood hustle. Got to respect the hustle. But
yeah.
I'm telling you.
For sure.
The Hollywood hustle is really not easy.
It's
people
not.
Think that they can come here and it's just going to happen overnight. But truthfully, these actors, especially the ones that are, you know, really big right now, Salma Hayek, these ones, they've been at it for like 20 years.
Right. Years
you know,
and
it
years.
Doesn't happen overnight.
Right.
So the Hollywood hustle is, I respect that. It's hard. Auditions are hard.
Yeah.
Sitting in the room sometimes with the whole, you can just feel it. Everyone's looking you up and down. They have, it's a whole process.
Yeah. It's a process of definitely getting to know yourself and, coming into self-acceptance.
Yeah.
And just staying on your side of the street.
Definitely. So when you get a script, what's like the first thing that you do? If you're going to get on board on a movie, what's the first thing that you do when it comes to your character?
What would be the first thing I would do? Well, I would find the me in the character. I would find how the character
relates to you.
Relates to myself, mm-hmm. and just, you know, look at all sides of it and not be afraid of any side of myself in order to find the character. And then I would probably research other people, you know, historically or in the news or whatever's current about a character like that. But you'd be surprised. You can find a lot of things in yourself if you just go inward. And
seriously, a lot of these, I mean, you look at like Johnny Depp. I mean, these guys mm-hmm. do like serious method acting.
Right.
They stay involved, like in character for weeks, even after the movie sometimes.
Right.
Have you ever like caught yourself? You're like, wow, I'm really in character right now. Like I'm not even on set and I'm still like involved.
Yeah, for sure. I would say, you know, more recently after Savages,
yeah.
I didn't realize it until, you know, maybe a couple months down the road, I was in class and I was just kind of moody and I just had different things going on. But my coach told me, hey, you know, you didn't drop your character yet. I was like, what do you mean I didn't drop my character? And I was kind of irritated. And
yeah.
I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah.
Pardon my language. And
I can curse. We can curse on the show.
Okay. I dropped the F-bomb a lot.
Yeah, it's okay. We curse on the show.
Okay. So he kind of clued me into the fact that I was carrying around the weight of that.
Mm, interesting.
And, you know, the personality of that. And it can be great if it's, a sweet, wonderful character. But if it's something darker,
yeah,
it's definitely, you have to make peace with it and find a way to move on from it. For
definitely.
Sure. And not, I don't know about everybody else, but for me.
Definitely. Well, you also have a sweet side because I heard you've been doing a lot of charities.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's awesome, girl. Well, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll talk about the charities that you're involved in. I'm huge into charities. So we'll talk about that. And it's also Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So we'll talk about all that. And we will take a break. And when we come back, more with Amber. Thanks, guys. And make sure you guys call in. The phone number is 323-247-7443. Your fans and friends can call in, by the way. Awesome. We'll be right back.
You let me ride. You let me rock. You let me slide. And when they looking, you let me hide. Defend my honor, protect my pride. The good advice, I always hated. But looking back, it made me greater. You always told me, forget the haters. Just get my money, just get my weight up. Know when I'm lying, know when I'm crying. It's like you got it, down to a science. Why am I trying? No, you ain't buying. I try to fight it, back with defiance. You make me laugh, you make me hoarse. From yelling at you and getting at you. Picking the dishes, throwing them at you. Why are you speaking when no one asks you?
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hey LA, are you getting out to vote on Tuesday, November 6th? I know I am. This is Lady J of Lady J's Wild World of Sports, and I'm joining my family right here, LA Talk Live, and encouraging the citizens of Los Angeles to get out and vote on Election Day. As you know, this is one of the most important elections in our American history, and we need everyone in LA to register and have a voice on November 6th. Currently, the state of California, the state we live in, has 6.5 million people eligible but not registered to vote. And about half of those voters live in LA County. So I'm joining the family here at LA Talk Live and encouraging you to register and vote on Tuesday, November 6th. And if you haven't yet registered, don't worry. You have until midnight on October 22nd, and you can now even register. That's right. If you have a signature ballot online with DMV or a state ID number, you can now register to vote at registertovote.ca.gov. And don't forget to join us here on Tuesday, November 6th for LA Get Out and Vote, our live Election Day coverage from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., where we're going to keep you tuned in exclusively to LA election news and poll coverage all day right here on my station, LA Talk Live. But we are more than just talk. Okay.
Journey Sisters is an organization that embodies and captivates women from all walks of life. Our membership includes for women that are constantly growing in the areas of personal development and community involvement. Monthly, we offer free leadership classes at McCade's Restaurant. Journey aims to inform women in the areas of heart disease and HIV and AIDS. Experience the journey now by logging into www.journeymosaicinc.com. Toll free 888-906-5519. Journey with no excuses.
Since 1871, Mountain Valley spring water has been bottled at the source in Hot Springs, Arkansas. Twice named the best tasting water in the world, Mountain Valley Water has served presidents, celebrities, and customers from coast to coast. Mountain Valley Water is naturally alkaline and bottled in glass, providing the perfect blend of nature's minerals for a crisp, clean taste. To start your home and office delivery in Southern California, call 1-800-499-9982. That's 800-499-9982. Or visit them online at www.mountainvalleywaterla.com. That's www.mountainvalleywaterla.com. All new customers will receive their first 2 5-gallon bottles absolutely free. Mountain Valley Water, the official hydrators of LA Talk Live, and proud sponsors of Here's to Your Health with Josh Lane.
Yeah. True. I am smoking on that gas. Life should be on Cinemax.
Welcome back to the show, everybody. It's your girl, Jennifer Tapiero. Every time I hear 2 Chainz rap, it makes me think I could be a rapper. I'm serious. You guys are my rap song, right? Can you just be quiet? Yeah, 2 Chainz, you're an all right rapper, dude. Whatever. Anyway, we're back here with my guest, Amber Dixon Brenner from the movie Savages. Welcome back to the show. Have you been having fun?
I've been having a lot of fun.
I know this is one of your first radio interviews, so I'm excited. Thanks for coming on the show. So you've been busy, not only, of course, shooting movies and working, but you've also been working with a charity.
Yes.
The Somali Mom Foundation?
Yes.
That is awesome. And I know Anna Lynn McCord hosted it from 90210.
Yes, she did, yeah.
So tell us about the event. What was it all about?
So the event was it's a lovely event. I'm having like a brain. I'm remembering the whole thing. I'm putting it back together. It's basically a charity that supports children and getting them out of brothels.
Oh, wow.
And rehabilitating them. And so going and hearing the whole, hearing everything about the foundation and listening to the experiences that people had and coming out.
It's pretty crazy, huh?
It's absolutely crazy. So crazy that when I talk about it, I just get like so shooken up.
Well, it's nuts to hear about the things that are actually going around the world. You're like, wow, that really is happening?
Yes.
It's nuts to think nuts. That, you know, this stuff is happening.
Right. And I have 2 little boys. Aww. And so when I went, I obviously removing children out of any abusive situation is something very close to my heart. But especially since having my children and just seeing how development leads to the creation of society, developing mm-hmm. small people, our future, it just really broke my heart to let that into my world. Like, whoa, this is taking place. This takes place a lot. And it's something we all know in the back of our mind, but to really see it and be confronted with it and sit with it, you want other children to be well, and yeah. You want your children to grow up in a world where people are safe, children are safe. And so, yeah.
Oh, so you're a mother of 2.
Yeah, I have 2 little boys.
How old are they?
5 and 9.
Oh my yeah. God, how exciting.
Yeah, it's very exciting.
How do you balance like doing everything? Being a mom, being, you know, just trying to audition, do the acting thing, and just being a parent.
Right.
How do you balance it all?
I just do it.
You're like, I just do it.
Like anything in life, you try not to overthink it. You try to stay in your heart and just do it. You know, hit the beats, get them to school.
Was it like natural for you when you first had the babies?
Well, my first son I had when I was 20.
Oh, really?
And I was a single mom.
Okay.
So I did it all on my own.
Oh, good for you.
And it kicked in just like he came out and I held him and...
It's just natural.
It's just very natural.
That's what I heard because my friend just had a baby and she had a beautiful girl and she just turned like 8 months and she's just so pretty and she's just doing such a great job.
Yeah.
She had her 24 mm-hmm. and I'm like, girl, you look better than you did before the pregnancy. No offense to you, but you look better than you did.
No, that tends to happen.
She's
because
like,
nursing
I know, I look great.
And yeah, you really come into your woman and remember what's really, really important about life. You kind of get... out of yourself if you know if that tends to be your focus, you'll get out of yourself really quickly and into a bigger cause.
So having I grew up with all girls, so what's it like having boys? So must be really cool.
So I grew up with brothers.
Okay, so you know what it's like.
Mm-hmm, they were always very roughhousing me and
beating you up.
They kind of were, you know, we beat each other up. But not in like a serious way, you know, we were just rough. We were really rough and had a lot of fun. And so now having the 2 boys, they're rough and they're funny and they bug each other.
Do they like bugs?
Do they like bugs?
Yeah.
Like
guys are just like, they love bugs.
Like my 5-year-old who used to be so squeamish, he like loves picking up worms now and it's just so disgusting. And, you know, they can be really grody and...
Oh my God. Yeah. Did you bring them to set? Can you bring them to set?
I think my nine-year-old came very briefly with his nanny and they saw like, you know, where I was doing my makeup. They get very proud. They're super into movies and, you know, we're an entertainment family. So it's exciting for them.
Yeah,
and
of course.
To, you know, to look at something that maybe they want to
So do you think maybe they'll be actors also?
Yeah, for sure. My 5-year-old is like, you know, he's an actor. He doesn't need a stage.
Okay.
Yeah, he's just going to be a ham, and he steals every show. We're working on that. But yeah, I think for sure my older boy, he's more interested in like architecture, and so he says, well, maybe I'll do set design, or maybe I want to build
big
huge
dreams.
Buildings, or, you know, he's into architecture.
That's sick. And then your husband is a movie editor.
Yeah.
So difficult for editing. It's so hard. To find a good editor, I feel like it's really hard to find, because it's not easy. I mean, our people that we have, our edit, you know, our stuff, it's really hard. We have to find, like, the best, because editing makes either makes it look good or makes it look bad, you know?
Exactly.
If you don't have a good editor, the movie can go downhill.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
Yeah, so he's pretty good at what he does.
Is he?
For sure.
Well, you said he worked with Oliver, so he must be, like, the top
editor.
Yeah,
he really has earned and achieved a certain place in his career that, you know, people really admire.
Oh, wow. Who's he work with? Do anybody that we
right
know?
Right now, he's doing Superman.
What?
He's doing Man of Steel.
Oh, that's
so
sick.
Yeah, he's doing that. And
that is awesome.
Working with one of my favorite directors, Zack Snyder.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so that's pretty cool.
That really is awesome.
It's really cool for the boys. And obviously, I'm in love with Zack Snyder's filmmaking, so I love to, you know, see little tiny sequences.
Do they let you go to set?
No, I didn't go to set. David's not on set. He's in the cutting room. But a couple of times I've seen little...
Like, hey, get me on the set.
Right. Yeah.
Crash one of the scenes.
Yeah. That'd be funny. So, yeah, it's he's in the cutting room, and he really works his butt
long
off.
Long
hours. But it's been good hours on this movie, Zach's Family Guy. So, you know, it's nice.
Awesome.
It's been a nice run, yeah.
So you're doing a lot of good stuff. Anything else that we can be on the lookout for?
Not off the top of my head that I can think of. You know, just digging away at the acting, and I write. So, you know, it will all come together. It all
definitely.
Is together.
You're doing it, girl. You're doing it. Well, I can't wait to check out Savages.
Yeah,
everyone
go see
at home,
it.
Go check Savages out. It looks awesome. John Travolta, Blake Lively, Amber Dixon Brenner. It's gonna be really awesome. I can't wait to check it out.
Yeah,
when I saw John Travolta, I was like, I'm in. You know?
Yeah, for sure.
I'm going to see that. And are you on Facebook and Twitter, where our fans can also connect with you?
I am on Twitter, AmberDixon26.
Awesome. We'll tweet to you. Fans out there, tweet to her.
And Facebook. Oh, boy, this is pretty bad. I don't check my Facebook a lot, but I think it's Amber Dixon Brenner.
Okay, maybe if there's a few of you on there.
Right, for sure, Amber Dixon Brenner, I believe.
Well, let's go to a caller real quick before we take that break. Let's see who's on the phone. Caller, tell us your name. Where are you calling from?
It's your momager.
Oh, hey, how are you, momager?
How are you?
What's happening? Hello?
How are you?
What are you doing? I'm on the air.
Really? What are you talking about?
We're talking. We're about to take a break.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, what's going on with you?
Oh, just working.
Okay. We have an event tonight, Tyler Perry, or?
Where should I get John?
I don't know. We'll talk about it. I have to take a break.
All right, call me during the break.
All right. I'll talk to you soon, Momager. Keep working away. Momager PR. There she is. My mom knows where I'm at all times.
That's cute.
She finds me. Well, thank you so much, Amber, for stopping by. We really appreciate it. And congratulations.
Thank you.
Savages, that's huge. And we're looking forward to everything else that you're working on.
Thank you.
Thanks for stopping by. Amber Dixon Brenner. Big round of applause, everybody. Woo! And we're going to take a break when we come back. We have another guest in the house. She's on the Melissa and Ty Show on CMT. So we will be right back. Don't go anywhere.
But I know I won't forget her. And if loving her is wrong, then I just know I won't see heaven. She says she's from Seattle. She's 20 and some change. Before I get to TIA, I'm sure to make her rain. Then I back up on my plane. Chi-town, no hit. We spent some time and get some wine, have some miles from Harold's. I told her this is overrated, but I love your city, baby. Gotta get back to the D. You know we finally famous. Driver, drop me off in Dallas. I'm headed to some money. TSA be laughing, all the rubbers in your luggage. I know I'ma always leave her, but I swear I always love them. Tell her you'll probably find someone, but you'll never find another. Probably.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and hosts of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk. Say you're missing and you're wishing for some private time. Girl, could we get that way?
Got on my suede shoes. I'm in the great.
Hi, LA. Are you getting out to vote on Tuesday, November 6th? I know I am. Hi, this is Julie Orlov of Pathways to Love, and I'm joining LA Talk Live in encouraging the citizens of Los Angeles to get out and vote on Election Day. As you know, this is one of the most important elections in our American history, and we need everyone in LA to register and have a voice on November 6th. Currently, the state of California has 6.5 million people eligible but not yet registered to vote, and about half of those voters live in LA County. So I'm joining the family here at LA Talk Live in encouraging you to register and vote on Tuesday, November 6th. And if you haven't yet registered, don't worry, you have until midnight, October 22nd, and you can now even register online. That's right, if you have a signature file online with the DMV or a state ID number, you can now register to vote at registertovote.ca.gov. And don't forget to join us here on Tuesday, November 6th for LA Get Out and Vote, our live Election Day coverage from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., where we are going to keep you tuned in exclusively to LA election news and poll coverage. All day, right here on LA Talk Live, where we are more than just talk.
Hey everybody, this is Richard Carr inviting you to join me in the radio boardroom for the new Entrepreneurs Weekly Summit in my all new day and time. That's right, the new Entrepreneurs Weekly Summit is moving to Mondays at 5 p.m. Pacific. So don't forget, the new Entrepreneurs Weekly Summit, now Mondays at 5 p.m. Pacific, exclusively here on LA Talk Live, where it's more than just talk. We'll see you there.
Fly with the stars in the skies. I am no longer trying to survive. I believe that life.
That's my jam. That's Nicki Minaj. She's the reason why I rap in my bathroom. All right, welcome back to the show, guys. This is Just Chilling with Jen, and we are chilling. We have a beauty expert in the house. Everyone out there, you guys want to stay beautiful. She's the girl to talk to. That's why we brought her in the studio with Ann Marin with us. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me.
A fellow
me.
New Yorker. East Coast, what
that's
part?
True. That's true. Well, I'm actually from Manhattan.
Nice.
Yeah.
Every time you meet someone, what part? Right?
I know. Well, for, especially New Jersey.
Yeah, they're like, what part?
What part, what exit?
What exit, what? Yeah. And I forget where exit I'm from.
Yeah.
Because I was born in New York, but I was raised, make go, Queens, and it's crazy. Perfect timing. Southside Jamaica. Actually, my mom's from Queens.
Okay.
And then I was born in Long Island.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Long Island.
Long Island.
When I say Long Island, I get an accent.
So then it's like, oh, what the exit off the Long Island? L-I-E.
I'm like, I have no idea. I was born somewhere around there. No idea. So how long have you been in L.A.?
I moved here in 97, so it's actually been a long time.
A few years.
Yeah. But, you know, they say that New Yorkers either really adapt quickly.
Or they don't.
Or they run away.
Yeah, or they go back after a year. Yeah. I'm loving it. I'm stuck.
Yeah.
I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, you know, it's so beautiful here.
Yeah, the weather's nice.
I mean, it's October. It's 85 degrees.
I know. I'm wearing shorts. It's like no complaints.
Yeah, I might go surfing tomorrow. I mean,
that'll be sick. But I've been watching Shark Week, so be careful. You never know. So you were just on the Melissa and Ty show on CMT?
Yes.
I love Melissa, by the way.
Yeah,
she's on Dance with the Stars right now.
Yeah, she's so ridiculously beautiful.
Is she?
In person, she's even more beautiful.
Is she really?
You almost want to hurt her. She's so pretty. Yeah. It's.
Oh, you were the killer from the show. Okay.
Yeah. No, exactly. Well, actually, you know, my job was to give her beauty advice.
Really?
And, well, it was because she was, you know, coming here from Dallas.
Right.
And she, you know, the idea was that she's going to either stay in Hollywood and become, you know, really pursue her acting and being, you know, a reporter for GMA, you know, doing all the things that she's doing, or she was just going to go back to Dallas and be a wife and mom.
Mm.
So I was her intro to Hollywood and what she was going to have to do.
You were her tour guide.
Hair extensions, eyelash extensions.
Really?
You know, she can't go out without makeup, all that stuff. And, you know, frankly, between you and I, like, she really doesn't need it that much, but... You know, it's just part of the game
right.
in Hollywood.
So lash, big fan of the lash extensions.
Yeah.
I go to a place called Lashfully.
Yeah.
You have to go.
Yeah. Lash extensions are a big deal. You know, I have a salon and we've been doing them there since we opened.
Really? What kind? Are they silk or what kind of lashes do you have?
We use a company called Nova Lash. So they're, you know, they're synthetic, but it's really all about the glue. It's the glue that's the most important
thing. Oh, yeah. I've had some scary times.
Yes. Yeah,
you don't have weave glue on your eyelashes. That's right. That shit hurts.
Well, the glue that they use actually is the same glue, at least that we use, is the same glue that they use if you, say, had a cut on your hand and they didn't want to give you stitches.
Okay.
So they use actually glue in lieu of stitches, and it just kind of dissolves into your skin as you heal. So obviously, that's something that can touch the skin. You know, people generally don't have any sort of bad reaction
to it.
And it just dissolves naturally over time. So it doesn't, you know, your lashes don't pull out or anything
That's the worst. Damn. Because I've had some times where,
yeah,
it ended up bad. But I love Lashfully. It's a beauty lounge.
Oh,
it's like
a
place for women to relax and chill and get your lashes done. And they have, like, these beautiful fancy beds and you just take a nap.
Well, the experience is, you know, probably 3/4 of the
Customer service.
Thing. Yeah.
And while you're getting waxed, you know how painful that shit is. So you're in a comfortable bed and at least it hurts and you're getting it done.
Yeah. The place where I go near me for massages, because we don't do massages at my salon. I live near Kobe Bryant, actually.
What?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sure he gets tons of massages.
Well, he just one day stopped in this place to get a massage, and the girl who was up next, who happened to be the girl that I go to, was such a huge Kobe Bryant fan that she couldn't bring herself to perform the massage. She went in, she was like going to touch him, and then she just walked out and said, I can't do it. And
she gave up.
Yeah. She gave it to the next girl.
Oh my God.
I mean, you can imagine, because, you know, I think she romantically, you know, like pined for him.
So she gave up halfway in.
She was just like, I can't bring myself to be a professional.
I can't. She was going to do a John Travolta, wasn't she? Oh my God. Yeah. I'm just kidding. I love John Travolta.
Yeah, it might have gotten ugly in there. Yeah, and I think,
But obviously.
Yeah, yeah. Although Kobe Bryant can probably defend himself, I guess.
I think so. He's the Lakers, though, right? Okay.
Yeah.
I'm excited to check out the new season.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Us girls, we watch, you know, basketball for some different reasons.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, the Laker girls still bring it, man.
Whatever. We go to watch the Lakers.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
Who cares what the Lakers? Every time the Laker girls come out, I'm like, next, let's go. Come on.
Yeah, all the guys.
Let's go. Where's Kobe? No, actually, who's your favorite on the Lakers?
Well, I have to say Kobe only because he's, you know, kind of a neighbor.
Because he's black?
He's kind of a neighbor, so I feel like obligated. He's like, you know, the kid down the street, ended up being like, you know, a quarterback for the NFL.
Can you imagine? Like, she's the neighbor to Kobe. You come outside, he's playing in the cul-de-sac. You're like, what are you doing, Kobe?
Yeah, I got to tell you,
so cool.
He has no entourage.
Really?
And he shops for his, you know, dog food and milk all by himself, you know, at odd hours.
He's normal.
He's totally normal. He comes back from a game and he goes to the store for milk. I'm not kidding.
I love that.
Isn't that
That's
funny?
Cool. That's humble.
Super duper humble.
You know, I love Ron Artest. He actually calls in all the time on the show. He called in a few weeks ago from China.
Yeah.
I'm like, this guy is serious.
Yeah.
He called me from China. And he was speaking English. He didn't even learn Chinese.
Oh, yeah.
I know. Pretty cool. So that's cool. You're Kobe's a neighbor. You're hanging out with celebrities.
I know.
You're living the dream. So what else are you working on?
Let's see. Okay. So, we did the Melissa and Ty show, and I've actually been working on my own show.
Oh, very fancy.
Yeah. It's called Beauty Rehab.
That's sick. Great name.
Yeah. Beauty Rehab. And it's about people who take something that started as a good idea and maybe took it too far.
Plastic surgery?
Well, maybe more like the overly tan lady.
Okay.
We all remember.
Ooh, right. How can we forget?
Right. So it's like, you know, you figure one day she woke up and she was like, you know what? I just feel like I look healthier with a tan. But then, you know, she just took it to the extreme.
She never left.
Right. She never left. And
is she still on the news?
Yeah, I hear she is.
Like one of those girls from the Venice Boardwalk, the guys that work at Gold's Gym, the silver looking people.
What is up with that lady?
She looks actually like when I moved to LA, a friend of mine said, you know, even the homeless people look
better
healthy
than
New York because they're all tan.
They all have a little glow.
Right, exactly.
Snookified.
That's what she looks like. She looks like that she couldn't help it, that she was like exposed to the sun. Yeah.
Well, the spray tanning too. I used to be big into the spray tanning. Yeah. I like the tint, but now I'm over it. I gave up. The girl that I work with from Moonstar, she's like, you can't be tan. Give it up. Because I heard it's like killing people.
Well,
from the spray tans. Somebody went to the hospital after they got a spray tan.
Well, you know, it has chemicals in it and people can have an allergic reaction, and you know, you're not going in and doing a test beforehand, you're just going in there and getting sprayed.
So what would you recommend if you want to have a little glow, like a self tanner or
Well, okay, so I do like self tanner. I will tell you though that, you know, have you seen celebrities how they look orange on camera? It's because everything in HD picks up more red. It will show more red in a picture. So when you're looking at high definition, you know, images or video, you know, Lindsay Lohan or whoever, not to pick on Lindsay, but you know,
she's next. We'll talk about her next.
They tend to look a little orange.
So what's Snooki's excuse?
You know,
she always has cameras
she
on.
She probably throws a little more orange in there. But so the idea is that, you know, you got to realize you're going to look on camera. You're going to look kind of orange. So I would say never do your face.
Okay.
Only do like your legs, you know,
and your arms.
Right.
And
you can always use bronzer. I mean, it's only obviously
temporary. It's true.
You
can always fake it.
Yep.
So this show sounds fun.
Yeah.
Beauty rehab. So we have people like the lady that's too tan.
Right. So the idea is that you take these people and you have them confront their problem. So for example, tanorexic lady, you know, you would make her go without tanning for a week. And, you know,
I love that.
Right. And, you know, so she can confront her issue. And then, you know,
what do you think her deep rooted issue is?
Well, that we're not as concerned about.
Oh, okay. I'm trying to get like Dr. Drew on this. What's the real issue behind this?
I know, actually.
What are you hiding?
We thought about that.
You can bring me in. I'll be like, what's really going on?
Right, right.
Yeah.
So, and then basically we would reteach the person.
Okay.
So it's like, you know, people who go through some sort of real rehab, you know, they have to relearn how to be in society without doing this, you know, abusive.
This is hilarious. I love it.
So they are used to like, you know, say, teach this lady about bronzer, for example.
Oh, nice.
Right? Or, you know, show her different ways.
Here's a bath. Here's a shower. Right. Scrub this off.
Right. So, but it's also a way to like introduce new products and talk about what the latest greatest makeup and, you know, things in the industry are.
That's cool. So what about people with like too much plastic surgery? Are you doing stuff like that too?
Yeah, plastic surgery is tough because, you know, once
can't
you
can't undo
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
yeah.
Once
can't
you,
go back.
Yeah, you can't go back. You know, but in general, I think what happens is one leads to another.
Mm-hmm.
So you do have people that kind of are in this rut. They get stuck and so focused on something that they perceive as a flaw.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, what we're trying to do is kind of have them move past that by confronting that and then just kind of saying like, hey, you know, you don't have to wear, for example, fake eyelashes to the gym. There's something called lash extensions that are going to look more natural. And you're not going to look like a spider lady, and people aren't going to be afraid of you.
Spider lady. I wanted to ask you about eyebrow tinting.
Because
I was getting a facial yesterday. I was waiting, you know, and I couldn't help but laugh. But I was sitting there reading my magazine, and then this lady looks up, and she comes up, and she has blonde hair.
Right, right.
And she comes up, and she has these black, like Halloween eyebrows. And I was like, whoa. Wow. And I'm like, what is that? And I'm looking at her like I've never – I'm like, whoa. Like, what
– So they had the tint on her eyebrows.
A little too dark, though. But I was like, I should have brought you in for the beauty rehab because she went too black with her eyebrows.
Yeah.
And she had blonde hair.
Yeah.
So how do you match the eyebrows? Like, I've seen, like, opposite sometimes people have dark hair, too light of eyebrows.
Right.
Kind of important to
have
matching.
Yeah, exactly. You don't – you know, you don't necessarily want to go matchy-matchy.
Mm-hmm.
Your eyebrows tend to be a little bit darker than your natural hair color. But yeah, you don't want to go extreme.
I was like, whoa.
Like you couldn't take your eyes off
her. I had to ask her. I was like, and I said that, I hate to ask you this, but what's going on? Can we talk about this?
Right, exactly. Well, you know, with eyelash tinting, if you're going light, you can really just use a little bleach on your eyebrows just for like 5 minutes.
Okay.
Not even, like a minute. And it will just take that, just the edge off the darkness if say you've done highlights on your hair. The one thing I can tell you is that you should never use the same dye that you use on your hair. You should never use those on your, that on your eyebrows, because it's you know, it can get into your bloodstream. You know, when you're putting something on your scalp, there's sort of a, you know, a longer distance between the surface, you know, of your skin and your bloodstream. But right here, it gets right into your bloodstream. Exactly. So
sounds like a beauty disaster.
It can be. And people, you know, what happens is people will be at home and use like box dye, and they'll just be like, you know, taking a finger and like blit. And then you're like, no, because you can have a bad reaction.
Have you had like any friends that have just had terrible beauty disasters? Any good stories? Well, any juice?
I have good stories. Okay, so when I was in beauty school, we used to get people coming in to beauty school all the time who'd had hair disasters. And I'm thinking, really? This is where you want to come?
Yeah.
After, you know, this disaster? I mean, okay. These people are just learning, you know. But we had this girl come in. And she's a young girl, probably like, you know, 18. Mm-hmm. And she had decided to dye her hair black. I mean, you know, deep, dark black.
Oh, I did that one time.
Okay. And then once she had done it, she decided, I don't like this. I'm going to go back to blonde. So she just took a whole bunch of bleach, put it on her head, on her hair, and fell asleep accidentally. And woke up, and all, of course, her hair was just falling out in chunks.
Ooh.
Yeah. And she had long, probably like waist-length hair.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So she came in. And she was crying, and basically everybody in the school, like all of us, were like, oh, we felt so bad for her, you know.
That's terrible. She probably got so drunk she passed out.
Yeah, you know, exactly. Like, it seemed like a good idea at the time. But, you know, you shouldn't, you know.
Leave it to the experts, people.
You should. I mean, these are powerful chemicals.
Seriously, you know? That's why we need people like you.
Yeah.
So do you have a website? So meanwhile, people can be checking it out.
Yeah. You can check out my website. It's www.annmerin.com. So ANNMERIN.com.
Awesome. So you're basically the celebrity go-to beauty expert.
I am.
So people just call you up and like, hey, I have questions.
Yeah, you know what? I learned all this because I had questions.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. I was this person that wanted to know everything, and I felt like I couldn't get any answers.
Right.
So I feel like I went undercover and kind of learned all the secrets.
Undercover beauty agent.
And I will tell you all the stuff that nobody else will. I'll tell you good stuff.
So tell us about some good products right now. First of all, I'm a product junkie. I've tried thousands of products. You go to these gifting suites. You know, your publicist knows. You come home with Christmas shopping bags. And you go to try these products, and they end up being, I'm not sure. Goes underneath my bathroom, you know.
You just don't have time to try it.
Yeah, and some, like, products are better than others.
Yeah.
So I've been working with a few good products. Bellavani.
Right.
I have to get you a bottle. You're gonna. Yeah. It's $80.
Yeah.
But they're doing trial offers and stuff, and I can send you a bottle for free. But it's an anti-aging cream.
Mm-hmm.
Helps with brown spots. It helps with fine lines.
Right.
It helps with pimples.
Right.
And it's so good. All these celebrities have been trying it and having really good results.
Oh, good, good.
So I really like that company. I've been working with them doing some infomercials and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been trying that. And then, of course, Moonstar, the company that I've been working with, the makeup line.
Right.
So we'll have to get you some of that.
Oh, yeah.
But do you know any, like, amazing products right now?
Well, you know, I'm crazy about airbrushing.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, airbrush makeup?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. I actually...
You have a machine.
Yeah, well, I have a machine. We have a professional machine, certainly. But now they have the consumer model. Temp2 has a great consumer model. And frankly, it's right up there with the professional. You know, you don't have as much precision control over the tape. But, you know, you can basically get, you know, right where you need to go. You can cover up pimples. You can hide fine lines.
Can it give you a six-pack? That's all I care about.
You could do your own six-pack.
That'd be sick.
Or you could do it on somebody else.
Okay.
Yeah.
Get a situation going.
Yeah. But I'm crazy about it because actually I had a little incident. I was surfing and I face planted.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Wait. And I like scraped the whole front of my face.
Ah.
And the first thing I did... You know, besides making sure that I wasn't dead, was run in the house and airbrush my face, and you couldn't tell.
How bad? Wait, we have to talk about this.
Yeah.
So you surf.
Yeah.
You fall right on your surfboard.
Yeah. Well,
What happened
was I face planted into the sand. So I sort of exfoliated the front of my face.
Oh, no.
Like, not meaning to.
Oh, my God.
I mean, a good exfoliation is good, but not like that.
Oh, so right after, you're like almost bleeding. You're like, I'm going to go airbrush.
Yeah, exactly.
I love it.
Yeah, and so I really love airbrushing.
What don't you like? What's a no for Hollywood? I mean, you work with all these celebs and stuff.
Yeah. The no is definitely people who overuse makeup. Mm-hmm. Let's say you're doing a really beautiful, dark eye.
Smoky eye can go really wrong.
Exactly. Mm. You don't also want to do a red lip. You want to do one or the other.
Keep it nude.
Yeah.
Balance it.
Right, exactly. Yeah. You need to balance your makeup. So you shouldn't, you know, go, if you're going to do something, don't
go ham.
Yeah. Basically, don't look like, you know, you're about to do some sort of Christian talk show.
Who's like the worst, you think, right now? You're like, oh, you need a little bit of a beauty makeup. You need some beauty rehab, sweetie.
Yeah. I'm trying to think.
I mean, I don't like to talk shit. I just like to call people out sometimes.
I hate it when people who are naturally beautiful, like, Lindsay Lohan's a good example, where she is just not feeling beautiful, so she's getting stuff done to herself.
Yeah, the lips.
The lips, and, you know, she's fixing what ain't broke. Yeah. You know, I mean, I understand that people have insecurities. Let's say, you know, somebody just always feels their whole life, they're like, oh, I've just hated my nose my whole life. I mean, I understand that. But Lindsay Lohan, for example, is a beautiful girl. Like, just leave well enough alone.
I feel like Lindsay looks like she's like a hot 50-year-old trying to look younger.
You
like,
can't
she's
tell
like
her
25.
Age.
I know, to be honest, I'm 24. I just turned 24. So I'm like, she's in my age range.
Yeah.
And I'm like, she's not a good example for these people.
I know.
I see these people right now. Like, this is not something to look up to.
Right.
And she's constantly in the spotlight and it pisses me off.
Right, right.
Truthfully, it pisses me off.
Well, in Orange County, she would fit right in. Yeah. Because that's where I live. And
do you live there?
Yeah. And I got to tell you, it is plastic surgery central.
Oh my God. Yeah. That's good stuff.
I go to the supermarket and there are people there. At first, I thought they'd all been in like a fire. Like, I thought they'd had some sort of like reconstruct. You know, like when people are in a fire, their face burns off, so they have to use like their thumb as a lip or whatnot.
Oh my God. I know what you mean.
That's what it looked like. I thought there had been some horrible fire here in Orange County.
Oh my God.
Then I realized that they had done it on purpose. So it's actually
the trend.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, it's interesting, you know, because we're from New York. I came to California. I'm like, whoa.
Right, right.
It's kind of different in all these different cities, I think. But it's more, I think people like the lips, the duck lips.
Yeah.
The butt lips.
Right.
Too much.
Yeah, I don't understand what that's all about.
Wait, have you seen The Jersey Housewives? Please tell me you watched last night.
Oh, yeah.
Did you watch last night?
I didn't watch last night, but.
Oh, the reunion?
Oh.
It's the third week. Oh, I fell asleep, actually. I have to go back to TiVo to catch up.
Oh, really?
God.
You know what's funny is actually watching something like that, put your closed caption on and see how many, like, words that the closed caption person actually... I don't even know what that word was.
The husbands make up words now.
Right.
The husbands were fighting, and I was literally like, you're a fool. You're a fool.
Right.
They're going back and forth. I'll kill you.
Right.
I'll kill you. You touch my balls. They're going back and forth, these two. I'm like, ping. I'm like, oh my God. One's going to kill each other. Let's see a fight. These 50-year-old women and these husbands are fighting like cats and dogs.
Oh, it's just crazy. And it must be exhausting.
I see. Well, you know, New Yorkers, they kind of are like that sometimes.
That's true. Right. You know,
but not that crazy, though.
I know.
Jersey, though, is worse.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, they, you know, they represent on that show.
I don't know if they represent.
Well, they're representing something. I don't know what it is exactly.
I don't know what's happening, but it's entertaining.
It sure is. Those people sure don't like each other.
And Teresa's forehead?
Oh, yeah.
That's a beauty rehab.
Yeah.
Maybe she needs a little beauty rehab.
Yeah.
She needs a lift.
Yeah.
Is she wearing a wig or...
You know, it's really hard for me to tell.
Yeah.
But yeah. Oh, that's another thing. That's my little pet peeve I have is, you know, wigs. Is bad wigs in movies. I mean, it's a movie. Like, you've had a lot of time to prepare. You know what I mean? It's not like you just went bald and threw it on.
Why do you look like Kimberly from the Atlanta Housewives?
Right.
You know, that's one thing. Yeah. Why is this? She has perfectly great hair.
Right.
Why is she wearing that terrible weave?
I don't know.
The wig weave.
Yeah.
It's like she has weave and wig.
I know. It just, again, it's
it
like...
It bothers me.
Fixing something that you broke, and now you don't even look like a real person.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I think we're, you know, in society, we're kind of taking things to an extreme, and it's probably time to come back down, right? Everyone needs to go to beauty rehab, apparently.
Yeah. Well, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're talking about beauty rehab, and I wanted to talk about Jersey Housewives, Teresa's spray tan.
Okay.
She was a shade of... orange, yellow, and like grease.
Yeah.
You know, it was like a different type of color.
Like a sun that was.
I wonder what she asked for when she got from the tan. She's like, can I look greasy?
Right.
Can you make me look greasy?
The oily look. I want to look oiled. Like, she wanted to look oiled up, you know. Like,
can I look so oily? Oh, my God. All right, it's getting crazy in the studio. By the way, our phone lines are open. So fans and friends can call in. Maybe your OC friends can call in.
Yeah.
Hopefully they won't be offended. It's 323-247-7443. And when we come back, we'll also be talking fashion. We have a fashion designer in the house.
Oh, great.
So from beauty and fashion, it's going to get, like, girl talk right now.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. We'll be right back. Let's do it. Cheers.
Make it nasty, make it nasty. Drop it on the bitch, make it nasty. Make it nasty, make it nasty. Pop it on the bitch, make it nasty.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Bottled at the source since 1871, Mountain Valley Water is the deepest operating spring in America. This naturally alkaline water, with a perfect blend of minerals, has a crisp, clean taste that's twice been named best tasting water in the world. Mountain Valley Water has been served in the White House for 13 presidents, but it's also served kings, including Elvis Presley, whose only requirement on tour was 2 6-packs of Mountain Valley Water. Delivered to your home or office in glass bottles, Mountain Valley Water will give new customers in Southern California their first 2 5-gallon bottles free. For more information, call 1-800-499-9982 or visit us online at www.mountainvalleywaterla.com. Mountain Valley Water is the official sponsor of Here's to Your Health with Josh Lane on LA Talk Live.
Journey Sisters is an organization that embodies and captivates all walks of life. Our membership includes 44 women that are constantly growing in the areas of personal development and community involvement. Monthly, we offer free leadership classes at McCade's Restaurant. Journey aims to inform women in the areas of heart disease and HIV and AIDS. Experience the journey now by logging into www.journeymosaicinc.com. Toll free 888-906-5519. Journey with no excuses.
Said it must be, cause a nigga got dough. Ordinary swag in the mouth full of gold. Hoes at my shows, they be stripping off their clothes. And the college girls write a nigga name on it.
All right, welcome back to the show. Hopefully you guys are enjoying. So far, so good, huh? And we have Ann Aaron in the house, who's a beauty expert. She was on the Melissa and Ty show on CMT. Also has a show that she worked on TLC. We'll talk about that. We have another guest in the house. We have a fashion designer who's going to be showcasing her work on this upcoming event, Fashion Minga, for LA Fashion Week. Let's welcome Miss Jumpin' in the house. Woo-hoo. Marissa.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Should we jump?
Yes.
Jump. She does a jumpsuit, so I love the name. Tell
Thank
us
you.
About, you know, the name of the company.
Thank
it's cool.
You. Thank you. The name, well, my name is Marissa, and I love S's.
Okay.
So it just kind of works because my nickname is Missy.
Okay.
And it just flows.
It just works.
Yeah, it just
You're
works.
Working it.
Yeah, and then the whole jumpsuit thing. And I really wanted to have a feminine name that everybody could remember. So
it's cute.
Thank you.
I'm loving it. So you're going to be showcasing your jumpsuits at this week's LA Fashion Week.
Yes.
Fashaminga, yes. Which I'm hosting which will be fun. I'm excited to see the jumpsuits.
Yay.
And I'm going to be rocking one on the red carpet.
Good. Yes. Yes.
Hello.
Yes. And they,
she brought them.
Yes, I did.
Fancy.
So this is our Miss Tune.
Oh, that's cute.
So it's reversible.
Like comic booky.
Yes, it's reversible.
Ooh.
So it can go either this way. It can go either this way or it can go this way. So it's reversible.
Oh, cool.
And then I have Miss Class. Ooh. So this one.
Obviously, that's not the classy one. Just
no. It's not. This is the one you can just be crazy in and jump
just
in.
Turn around.
And this one is Miss Class, and it's available in several other colors.
Ooh. I'm just figuring if Miss Ass can fit in this.
Oh, well,
I wonder if my ass can fit in that jumpsuit.
Well, you know what? If your ass doesn't fit, we can make it, you know, make other adjustments.
We can cut somewhere and pull it.
Yes, yes.
So cool. So how did you start this company?
Well, I love jumpsuits. Mm-hmm. They're like so bomb. And
they are bomb.
They're easy to slip in and slip out of. So my problem was I couldn't find them anywhere, and I couldn't find mm-hmm. cute ones that I would like wear, even though I did find some, but it just wasn't enough. So I was like, you know what? I should just make them.
Just do it. Look at that. I'll just go downtown, find somewhere down the alley, get some fabric, and let's do this.
That's exactly what I thought.
That's cool.
Yeah, so it's working out, and, you know, I just started this year, so I'm really, really excited about it.
So a year old, that's it.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, congrats. Well,
jumpsuits are really in.
So jumpsuits are in. Yeah. Well, she's a beauty expert, so yeah. what do you think about jumpsuits?
Well, first of all, I love purple, so, you know,
me
she's really rocking the purple here. But, you know, the best thing about jumpsuits is that, you know, you don't have to pick both a top and a bottom.
Exactly.
Right. Know? Just easy.
Yeah. Very easy.
It's an easy way out.
It is.
That's what I think.
Or easy way in.
Yeah, exactly.
Because it's an easy outfit. I feel like it's kind of like, for me, I like to wear jumpsuits because I'm lazy.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the truth.
Yeah, and if you're like on the go and you don't know what to wear and you can't throw anything together, there's your jumpsuit.
Yeah,
throw it
jumping.
On. Go. Jump in it and go.
I love it.
That's
what's the website so people can log on right now and go buy this right
yes,
now, people?
Yes, it's www.missjumpin.com.
I love it. So you have how many different types of jumpsuits?
I think there's about 14 on the website now, but I'm actually currently creating the fall line and working on that. And also, in Fashaminga, I have a spring-summer 2013 line that I have created. So that's going to be what's
bright
going.
Bright colors.
Bright colors, fun colors, exciting. It makes you feel young and feminine and just sexy and hot.
I love it. So we got the fashion designer and then we have the beauty expert.
Yes.
So we got the whole table. So people out there, if you guys want to call in with questions, there's a lot of women out there that are struggling. They need our help.
Oh, yeah.
You know, with fashion, they're struggling maybe with the beauty stuff.
Oh, yeah.
So we'll be here to give tips for the next half an hour or so. So make sure you guys call us, 323-247-7443. And if you want to check out her clothing, make sure you check out Fashaminga and Fashaminga.com. Buy your tickets. If you're cheap, buy them now. Otherwise, they're $20 at the door. $20 at the
Perfect.
Door, not bad.
Not bad at
no,
all.
You
bad.
Know, Fashion Week. Did you ever go to New York Fashion Week?
Yeah, I've
good
you know,
stuff.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy there. I mean, you think LA Fashion Week is crazy? New York is much crazier.
Yeah, LA's not as crazy.
No, no.
They just want to get to the bar. I feel like at the fashion. Every time I've been to the Fashion Week, they're just crazy because they want to get to the drinks.
No, you're right.
You know,
you're right.
It's like
you're...
relax. We're here for the fashion show.
Right, exactly. Like the fashion is just back, like a backdrop to the drinking.
Yeah.
Like oh,
background music.
Like I went to a bar last night and there were some people walking around in outfits. I think,
I'm not sure.
Right.
Well, the good thing about Fashaminga is there's going to be performers and
yes.
performances during the show. So
45 performers.
Right.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
Too much.
Yeah.
No, I'm just kidding.
No.
It's a lot. It'll be fun.
No, it's going to be amazing. I'm so excited.
It's going to be cool. Well, congrats, though. You're going to be, like, working with a bunch of cool designers, too.
Right.
So do you know what – are you coming out first, second? Do you know
– I'm actually going to be fourth. And
fourth?
The artist that's going to be performing before me, I chose her. And her name is SpankyValentine.com.
Oh.
And she's beautiful and she's gorgeous. And they're comparing her to a female prince. So,
oh, really?
Yeah, it's going to be exciting.
That's sick.
So when you see her, then you know that I'm coming out. So.
Oh, my God. Pretty exciting.
Yeah.
So a lot of things could go wrong, though. They could fall.
Right.
They could not fit in the outfits. Are you a little scared about
well, no.
what's going to happen?
We had a rehearsal already on Saturday.
Good.
So we're good. We're ready.
You're ready to go.
Yeah.
I bet the models love wearing these
jumpsuits. They do.
I know.
They love them. When they step in them, they're so excited because – you know, they're so fun and colorful, yeah, and it's easy to get on too. So.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like they just slip them on, they go out there, they do their thing.
That's true.
That's why I'm awesome. Doubling all the models up. So,
yeah,
no, I could if I wanted to jump in, jump out. Let's go.
Awesome. So any other tips that we can let's talk about some beauty tips now for the fall, and let's talk about some fashion do's and don'ts.
Okay, well, for the fall, definitely, you know, you're switching from your nude, really natural looking makeup, and now you're picking some darker colors. Mm-hmm. So you're obviously going to see wine lipstick shades. Mm-hmm. You're going to see darker eye makeup.
Right.
Really, I always say just pick your signature color for that season. So, you know, really like a burgundy or a wine lipstick shade will kind of transition maybe your look that you were using during the summer and have it be more contemporary.
Right. What would you wear with like your jumpsuits, like with that purple?
Yeah.
Because I'm like, I'm going to maybe be rocking one of those on the red carpet. So I got to decide what kind of makeup I'm going to be rocking.
Yeah. And I mean, you know.
That's cute.
That is so cute.
I love it.
Yeah. I mean, you know, you don't want to have makeup, obviously, that's going to compete with that beautiful piece.
Right.
So, you know, I mean, you know, you could really do like a really pretty sparkly eye, mm-hmm, and pick up the sparkles in that outfit.
That'd be cute.
You know what I mean? I don't like necessarily the, you know, matchy. Like, I wouldn't necessarily go try to find this exact perfect purple lipstick or eyeshadow. No. But just kind of playing off, you know, it's shiny. So maybe doing some satin finish or, mm-hmm, you know, something. Maybe some sparkly lashes.
That'd be cute. And what about the comic book one?
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's really cute.
This is Miss Toon.
Miss Toon.
Everything is Miss.
Toon-chi. What is that? Little Wayne always says that.
Yeah, he always does. So it's reversible. You can wear it this way.
Cute.
Or you can wear it this way.
Oh, that's fierce, girl.
Ooh, I love that.
Love that.
This way.
Oh, I love that.
You know what I love this for is like, you know, for over bathing suit, like all of a sudden you're, mm-hmm, ready to go out. You know what I mean?
Today's the day.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm going to wear that right now.
Yeah.
Sick.
Yeah.
And you know, also I wanted to talk about the show that you just worked on before we wrap up the show.
Yep.
You just did a show on TLC.
Yes. Wedding Day Makeover.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. So it was really working with brides who, you know, in their normal lives, they're just regular people. They're not actresses. They're not models. Mm-hmm. So all of a sudden their wedding day comes around and they have no idea how to do their hair and makeup,
right,
for that sort of glamorous look that they want. So our job was to basically give them a makeover for their wedding. You know, whether they wanted to look like Hollywood glam or, you know, more sort of Cinderella, and, you know, helping them, like, basically we would do two looks on each bride and then all their family and friends would kind of take a
vote. So you were like a consultant. You come in and you tell them what's what's not really.
Yeah. I mean, we'd listen to what the wedding all about the wedding, mm-hmm, and all about their personality. And then we would do two looks that we felt would work for them. And then it just came down to their wedding day. They would pick one look.
Awesome. Yeah. TLC. They have some great shows.
Yeah. And some, it was good when the moms wanted one look and the brides wanted something else.
That's where the drama comes in.
Exactly.
Fun.
Yeah. Yeah.
Awesome. Are you going to be doing anything else that we can be on the lookout for?
Yeah. So the beauty rehab we're going to be doing. But I'm always, you know, I'm always out there. You know, I write a lot of articles and I'm sort of always out there, you know, giving people the 411.
The scoop. Yes,
yeah.
On beauty.
Yeah.
Awesome.
You know, I'm not here to tattle on anybody, you know, let's say, you know, people who are wearing hair extensions or whatever, but I'm here to let the regular person know that, you know, everybody can look like a celebrity, right?
Everyone can look like a star.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
Well, we appreciate you stopping by and hanging with me. You got to come back and chill.
Oh yeah.
You have to come chill with Jen. You have to. And Marissa, Miss Jumpin'.
Yay.
I'm excited for you, girl.
Thank you.
This is like your big debut this week.
It is.
LA Fashion Week?
It is. It's my first LA Fashion Week, so I'm super excited.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
So where can people check you out? Tell everybody the website, your Facebook. Are you on Twitter?
Everything is under Miss Jumpin'. So Facebook, Miss Jumpin'. Twitter, Miss Jumpin'. Instagram, Miss Jumpin'.
Okay.
And www.missjumpin.com.
Awesome. Yay. Well, thanks for stopping by as well.
Thank you for having me.
Definitely.
Thank
with this economy, the prices aren't too high.
No. Everything usually is under $100.
Oh, that's good. Awesome. Well, we appreciate you two for stopping by the show. Just chilling with Jen. Check it out, everybody. Fashion Minga. Go to fashionminga.com. Get your tickets now. There's supposed to be like 2,000 people at the show, and doors open at 8. And there's my rap song in the background.
Oh,
yeah. God's gift to me. Yeah. So that's the end of the show. We'll see you guys next time. Yay. I go live on Thursday night at 6 p.m. StarCam Radio, where we talk about celebrities. So I interview a lot of stars and stuff. So if you guys want to check out some past interviews, log on YouTube, StarCam Celebrities, log on StarCam.com. Otherwise, I'll see you at 6 p.m. And next up, we have a show at 3 o'clock. What's her name? Susan.
3 o'clock, Masterminds Live, hosted by Susie Pruden.
Awesome. Check out the show, guys. Stick around, and we appreciate you checking out LA Talk Live. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks, Ann. And thanks, Mish Dumpin, for stopping by. And tell everybody that you were chilling with Jen.
Oh, yeah. Love chilling with Jen.
Love chilling with Jen. Thanks, girls. And make sure to check out my Facebook, Jennifer Top Hero. See you next time. And I love her so much, and I love how she loved me back. She the best. So insane, our love, no games.
Y'all better catch up, we in the fast lane.
No matter where we go on tour, see us coast to coast, we taking on. More than just a fling, doing my toughest thing. And I never felt like this before.
If you try to hate the haters, be
still laughing now, haters.
Be quiet.
Y'all just jealous. We pulling up in the Bugatti. Nice body, chilling with my hottie in the lobby. And I care for my man. Yeah, I'm talking John Gotti. And baby, yeah, you hotter than Tabasco. A mad flow, you love it when I shake my ass, though. Sticks and stones will break my bones, but the haters will never find
and
me.
And no matter where we go on tour, see us coast to coast, we taking over. Before,
if you try to hate the
and no matter where we go on tour, see us coast to coast, we taking on.
Thank you for tuning in to LA Talk Live, reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we're more than just talk. Stay tuned.
Be quiet, haters.
Your girl Young Honey and my man Sam Stone, we back.